at Industry Giants with Katie Heckey here. And so you are with Brazen. You are actually the visual development artist at Brazen Animation.
That is correct.
And that's a fairly new company as well.
Yes, Brazen Animation is a super exciting startup company. We're just celebrating our second birthday today.
Happy birthday!
Woo!
And that's in Dallas, right?
And that's right here in Dallas. And local company. And Brazen Animation has big dreams. They're definitely going after wanting to join the industry giants.
You're here.
We're scrappy, we're tenacious, and we're making really cool art. We have an exciting short animation that should be coming out hopefully at the end of the year, which I've been working on for a long time, so super excited about that. And I've been with the company since the beginning, so we've just been growing and I've been growing along with it, so it's been an exciting new challenge.
Very cool. And you're from San Jose, California, right?
Yes, I'm from the Bay Area in California. I went to San Jose State University, and they have a fantastic animation illustration program there, and I just got the best education possible there.
And you were the president of the mysterious Shrunken Head Man Club, correct?
Yes, that is correct.
I've been dying to hear like all about this, so this is why I'm here.
Yes, the Shrunken Head Man Club has one of those names where people are kind of like, yes, tell me more, is that a cult? And you're like, no, kind of, no.
Yes, no.
The Shrunken Head Man Club is an organization of animation illustration students at San Jose State University who came together, and the club started small, like 15 or 20 people. It just celebrated its 20th anniversary and now has like hundreds of alumni all over the United States, all over the world, in different all different aspects of the industry.
And that's all because of you, right?
It's not all because of me. It's all her. I was only president for one term, but it is a fantastic club, and it really creates this wonderful student culture there, and they bring in guest speakers from the industry, they have lectures, they have workshops, and they're just extremely silly and full of some of the strangest, loveliest people you will happen to have a glance of, and they are just lovely working in the industry.
I mean, what are some of like the craziest things that you guys did with the club?
The club has actually had many dynamic events, everything from simple things like we have fantastic Halloween parties with intense costume contests, people coming as bottles of sriracha sauce and Batman and like the Morton Salt girl. But then it's also taken sometimes a more serious and active role in the campus. During my presidency, we led a demonstration of several hundred students and wrote a petition with several hundred signatures to try and get more classroom space and resources allocated to our animation illustration club. It blossomed tremendously over like the short years it was there, and now is a very impacted program. So the club definitely tries to stand up for students and making sure they have as many available resources as possible within the school, and to kind of stand up for that, because it's a very large university and there's tons of different programs, and we want to give our students every opportunity to shine within that.
That's very impressive. So let's talk more about Brazen. Just give us a whole history. It's the 2-year history on its birthday.
Okay, so Brazen Animation, we have a wonderful leadership. We've got Brian Ingram, who came from Real Effects, Brian Cole, Ryan Iltis, Greg Lyons, Jasmine Johnstone, and they kind of came together to form this studio based on what they were really passionate about. And that was not just making a company that was going to do well and make a quality product. It was about making a company that could tell stories with meaning and purpose.
That's your slogan, right?
Yeah, that's definitely our slogan, and that's what we're all about. And they want to be a game changer in the industry, and they want to come from a fresh perspective, an outside perspective, and to maybe take more daring, creative decisions is the goal. And so they've hired this amazing studio, because it cracks me up. I feel like my boss, Brian, it's almost like he's trying to herd cats, because he's hired all of these really passionate, stubborn, determined people, and it's a whole studio full of people who are like, I've got an idea, I want to share it, and he totally embraces that and cultivates that, and that's what the studio is all about. Everyone's super polite and super respectful, but very headstrong and determined, so it makes this wonderful, dynamic work environment where we're all trading ideas and like saying, like, have you thought about this? And like, wait, I've got an idea, hear this. And so for me, being fairly new out of school, it was such exciting and strange work environment to be thrown into right away, because I'm just here.
It's kind of like a fun school class almost. Kind of
yeah,
like,
well, but intimidating cooler. At first, but then very empowering later, because they want to hear those contributions. They want to hear the contradicting opinion. And I think that's what is going to ultimately
very
make
refreshing.
The studio really great.
No fear going into work. You just kind of say it all out.
No fear going into work. And it's just been cool being at the studio, because every project we get is a little bit better, a little bit closer to the kind of work we want to be doing. And I mean, we're starting out small, but some of the projects are really fun. Like, we, in order to fund all of our IP work that we're so passionate about, we do a lot of advertising to keep the lights on. And I've gotten to work up for like Hasbro Nerf doing Doomlands and Nerf Zombie Strike. And a lot of those fun things. So then whenever I'm at work, I'm like...
Do you get to shoot the guns at work?
Yes. I have a Flip Fury on my desk. Highly recommend the Flip Fury. That is the best Nerf blaster, hands down.
Not an old Maverick?
I wanted a Doominator for reference. It has four chambers and they all rotate. So it's like a giant Nerf Gatling gun. But I was not able to get one for my desk. So Nerf, still waiting on that.
She needs Doominator. That if you're watching. Well, very cool. And you've also worked with Hasbro too, right?
Yeah, worked with Hasbro. That's with Nerf Doomlands and Nerf Zombie Strike. We're working with several different companies. Solera Holdings is an interesting like insurance corporation. We tried to do some work for Radio Shack. Poor Radio Shack is no longer with us.
What about Chevy?
Chevy was actually my personal favorite project I've done so far, doing an animated short for Chevrolet. And that was fantastic, because I got to be very hands-on in every level of that process. So I got to do character designs, do backgrounds, work closely with everyone, designing all the assets that were going to go into there. And it has all these different like cards that are flipping up, so I was making literally like hundreds of tiny houses and trees and kind of engulfed in the madness of making this entire world for Chevrolet. And that was just a really fun project to kind of be creative overlord of.
That's amazing. So anything you'd like to finish up with, like what are y'all's projects in the future, what are your goals?
My goal is just to continue growing as an artist within this company, and I'm really excited to see where we go after this year, especially once we're able to show a lot of our secret upcoming work. And I just want to close on encouraging any of the students and aspiring professionals in the convention here to please come talk to me and ask me any of their questions, as well as to be open to the unusual career choice. I never expected that I would be here in Dallas. I had never expected I would be working at Brazen Animation. It didn't even exist when I was going to school. but it's been such an experience to be at this small company, to be able to play a very active creative role in what's made at the company, and to have close interaction with every level of leadership within the company. So I'd say that if you're a young person and you've got your big dream job, your big studio you want to work at, consider a stepping stone at a company like Brazen, because I think it will give you not only artistic prowess, but experience with leadership and being a professional.
And confidence, it
sounds
like.
And confidence. And it'll be a lot of fun. And plus, if you have an opportunity to move to work in a different part of the country, that alone is a growing experience worth having. Dallas is really different than California, and I love it.
Well, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you.